Hi all, this is Shoman. Now I am going to present detecting fake news spreaders on Twitter using Universal Sentence Encoder. So why fake news spreader instead of fake news detection? If we going to detect fake news individually, then we have to detect them individually and it is very time consuming and difficult. If we are going to use detect fake news spreaders, then it is more easy and we are going to detect it from the root, so there is no need of those news detecting separately. And are we going to use training pre-trained embedding? Yes, we are going to use Google's Universal Sentence Encoder. Now for this task, dataset is provided by the task organizer. You can find those dataset in this mentioned link. Here we are going to use deep learning methods to detect spreaders or fake news spreaders. Here we are mainly using LSTM based deep learning models. Now this is a snapshot of dataset which is provided by the organizer. Above one is English data corpus of a particular author, where I mentioned a particular author's 6 tweets for English and as well as a particular author's 6 tweets for Spanish data. Here 300 author's tweets are provided for English and 300 author's tweets are provided for Spanish for training purpose, and testing is done upon 200 authors' tweets for English as well as Spanish. So total 500 authors' data for English and 500 authors' data is for Spanish. But testing data is hidden from us. Now for the pre-processing parts, first we have to remove small a to z and capital A to z. Everything except small a to z and capital A to z. After that, we are going to remove all URLs, and after that, we are going to remove all HTML tags or elements, and finally, we are going to remove all emojis or emoticons present in tweets. Now, in this above mentioned chart, we can see that there are 150 authors for English, which is real author, and 150 author for English, which is fake author, and similarly for Spanish data, 150 is real and 150 is fake. So as we are mentioned earlier that each author, here we are going to train our data from for each author's 100 tweets. So total number of tweets which is real for real author is 15,000, and similarly for fake authors for English and real authors for Spanish and fake author for Spanish. Now these are the URLs that is present in real authors English dataset, that is 16,577. Similarly for fake authors English dataset, URLs are 17,119. Real author Spanish dataset, URLs are 10,887. And fake author Spanish dataset, URLs are 13,900. Hashtags are 54,366 for real author English, 46,722 for fake author English, and 48,216 for real author Spanish, and 14,065 for fake author Spanish. Now this is code walkthrough for pre-processing. This is first for document, we are going to provide our text, and here we are providing max length as 200. It is by default. If you are not providing anything, then it will take 200. First we are going to remove everything except small a to z and capital A to z, and after that we are going to remove URLs, then HTML tags, and ultimately we are going to remove emoticons or emojis, and lastly we are getting our text, pre-processed text. Now it is time for pre-trained embeddings. We are going to use universal sentence encoders. We are going to use two types of universal sentence encoders. First one is Universal Sentence Encoder Multilingual Large Version 3, and second one is Universal Sentence Encoder XLink NS. Here NS is indication of English and Spanish. Here first one is trained on 16 different languages, and second one is trained exclusively on English and Spanish dataset. Here this universal sentence encoder always give 512 dimensional vector as output, and we are going to provide this 512 dimensional output as an to an LSTM unit as input. We can see those as in the right picture. Here input is 512 dimensional vectors. These hundreds are 100 tweets of a particular author. Now code workflow for universal sentence encoder for XLink NS. First we have to import TensorFlow how, then NumPy TensorFlow sentence piece, and then we are going to take English and Spanish sentences and do this. Then we are going to import our module hub.module and mention this link, and then particularly we are going to use ns embed and we mention those text input, and we are getting our output. Similarly, for universal sentence encoder large version 3, first we have to import tensor TensorFlow hub, then numpy, then TensorFlow text, and we are mentioning some English text, Italian text, Japanese text, and then we are going to load our model. Then we are finding our output using embed and mention those English sentence or Italian sentence and Japanese sentence. Now, our architecture or framework of our this task. First, we are providing input S1, S2, S3, S100. Here, S1, S2, S3, S100 are 512 dimensional vector which are we are getting from those universal sentence encoder, and we are going to give those outputs of those S1, S2 and S100 to the LSTM as input. And then after that, an output of those LSTM is fed through the attention layer, and this attention layer is going through the sigmoid layer, and ultimately it provides the output. Now, code work through our framework. First, we are mentioning that is our sequential. Then we are going to mention LSTM with 256 unit. Then return sequence is equals to true, input shape 100, 512, dropout is equals to 0.3, and recurrent dropout 0.2. Then we are going to add attention layer, then dense activation sigmoid layer, and ultimately we are compile our model using Adam optimizer and using loss function as binary cross entropy, and we are going to use matrix as accuracy because we have balanced dataset. Now, attention. For attention, we are going to use following example. Like, this is taken from Twitter. Breaking news: Tom Hanks and his wife Rita Wilson announced Wednesday that they have tested positive for the coronavirus. Here, to predict the word coronavirus, we should give more emphasis on tested and positive instead of Tom Hanks and Rita Wilson. But here, we are going to use this as a sentence level instead of word level, because in this case, we are provided 100 tweets of each author, so we have to provide the relative importance to those fake tweets instead of real tweets. We have to apply the attention model which is present in Bahadono's paper. Now, code workflow of attention. In this code workflow, we are going to mainly focus on this call function. First, in this call function, we are going to multiply our W with X. W is the weight function and X as input. Then we are going to add our bias. Then we are pass through this W into X plus B within the tanH function. Then after that, we are going to pass it to the softmax and expand dimension, and we are getting the output. Now, experiment and result. In this chart, we can see that we are going to use two different types of encoder and with different batch size. And in this case, we trained our model in both languages. So first, we are going to use universal sentence encoder multilingual with batch size 16 and number of training data. Here we are splitting our data into 8:2 ratio, 480 for as total our data is provided. 600, so 480 for training and 120 for validation. We are getting 77.50 accuracy for batch size 16, 30 for batch size 32, we are getting 74.90 for 64, we are getting 74.75, and for Xling English Spanish 1, we are getting 80.83 for 16 batch size. For 32 batch size, we are getting 77.50, and for batch size 64, we are getting 81.50% accuracy. So we are getting highest accuracy for universal sentence encoder Xling English Spanish 1 with batch size 64. Now, in this case, we are going to train our model separately for both the languages, and we are going to use universal sentence encoder multilingual large version 3. And we trained our data with batch size 60, and we are getting accuracy 63.33 for English and for Spanish 80%. So more or less we are getting 71.50% accuracy if we average those two terms. So in the conclusion, we can say that we are going to use universal sentence encoder Xling NS1 as those are exclusively trained on English and Spanish data, and we are getting 64% accuracy in English test data set and 80% accuracy on Spanish data set. But the accuracy in real world actually depends on how much PANS dataset reflects the real world dataset. Now, future works. There is a scope of improvement for English author detection, though we are using dropout and recurrent dropout but there is, I think there is a chance of overfitting. So in future, we should remove those overfittings and we can try different types of embeddings. We can also try BERT, but main problem for the BERT is we are limited to 512 words. Thank you, everyone.